Hello guys, welcome back. Another edition of the MCM vlogs in May. And look, new costume. So I am now Fumi Iwatani with my shield. So yeah, it's been a roller coaster. Trying to get this costume done for one and trying to get here for two. So yeah, anyway, con day. So yes, it's very exciting. I'm very happy to be back at another MCM. Obviously been, I guess, slight controversies this time. October's already, tickets already out, and it's like bumped up another £10 or a couple of quid. So it's like, okay, £100 for tickets and stuff. So yeah, it's crazy. So anyway, what can we do? But we'll see what happens after the con and see if people start boycotting and stuff. But yeah, overall, I'm not too badly impressed with the costume. It's obviously mostly all bought. Made the shield, chest plate myself. Made the shield myself, and yeah. I mean, it's not the best in the world, but you know, it will do. It will do. So I'm probably gonna wear this one for one day because you know it's just it's not the best one. It's fucking a ton of things going into it and. It's kind of clunky. So, yeah, I don't really know what we're going to be doing much this con. I got some things to sign. I've got some Yu-Gi-Oh cards to get signed by, you know, Sarah Kaiba and Dan Green. You know, Eric Stuart. So, couldn't move his name there for a second. So, yeah, that's going to be fun. I'm looking excited forward to seeing them guys. And, yeah, not much else really. Get Overhaul signed as well. Same guy that does the FNAF stuff, which is pretty cool. New FNAF trailer. So, yeah. I have a little pot around. So, it's just getting to the point where it's 10 o'clock, so I don't think we'll. I mean, we haven't done it for years, but I don't think we'll need an obligatory queue video because we haven't done that for a while now. So, yeah. Yeah, fun times. Can't wait. Yeah, not much else to say. I'm a bit lost for words this time. It's been an overwhelming morning for me. But anyway, I will catch you guys in the centre, which we are now just coming down on, and I just picked the wrong time to try and show the XL centre. There we go, there it is. Can you see? Can you see it? Can you feel it, Mr. Krabs? Can you feel it, Mr. Krabs? And yeah, we're gonna have a little bit of fun. We're gonna pot around and have some fun. So I'll see you guys in there. So for some reason we're going down this way, which is that way for some reason, I don't know why. Nice. So yeah, I don't know what we're going down here, but this is a new way. So interesting. We'll see where we go. Q video! There. So yeah, we are in Sony. I'm in, and I already hate my life. Oh wow, Chris and Rose. Damn. Oh man, I'm already super pissed off. And my DVDs, awesome. Oh. God, my costume's already falling apart and I hate it. Never, ever, ever wear capes. Never, ever wear capes. So I'm gonna have a quick little look around and see what I can see just on the first cursory evaluation. Let me put this fucking thing away, this lanyard.
Oh wow, they got fucking barriers around it now.
Yeah, we're gonna get upset.
Oh yeah.
Wow. Car of the Galaxy. Bit of a price there. Chanel House. Okay, cool. Oh. It's always a con when I see my Giovanni, man. And four, that's quite nice. Oh god, everything's in pain. I'm in pain in general. Not even just in pain, it's just a pain. So, Tokyo Toys, 24 man. Okay, cool. I'm gonna probably have a look at here at Brotherhood, often do, and we're gonna move to the next one in a minute. So, see you guys in a bit. Sit in the other hall now. And love that. So, yeah, it's still obviously early. I don't know what time it actually is, but I'm gonna go to Cosplay Central. Get some repairs done already, like last time, and fucking try to enjoy myself and cool down. Ooh, Mr. Roxas. I ain't that stupid. Cool. Love those people there already. Oh wow! Psst. A duck. No, wait, a goose. I'm an idiot. Oh, there's a pigeon. Don't know why that's exciting. But hey, something different. It's pretty cool. Wow, nice. Right, let's have a little bit of repair then. So, 10:45. That's pretty cool. 10:45, and all is right with my costume now. Thank God for safety pins. So, yeah. I'm gonna see if I can find a certain stall that does some pops, because they're do pretty nice. Cluzo, love that. They do some pretty good pops, so I'm gonna see if I can get to them first, and then I'm gonna see if I can find Kuma cards and then have a proper pop around, because yeah, now that my costume's fixed, that's awesome. That is awesome. Nice. Ooh, nice.
Channel
4. That's not them. Where are they at? This is a good one though, so I'm going to quickly look at these guys. See, they've got a Slifer. Actually, it's in a second, but I'll turn it off. Little look. Sorry, just trying to fix my costume. Batman Chase.
Thank you.
Yeah, the other section
is Stan Lee, wow. This one's only fucking filled out yet, so anyway, let's have a little look around. Oh yeah, look, it's gone. Okay, so managed to get some pops. That's my overall pop, my white ball from home. Depples, that's awesome. Hello, must be hot in there. Sorry. So yeah, I don't know what I'm doing, I don't know where I'm going. Oh wow, never shoot here, okay. Also talk to the other, now for me cosplayer, but he's busy talking, so I'm good. And again, I don't know where I'm really going. I don't know what I'm really doing. Just kind of pottering around. So look at some Lego stuff actually. See if we can have a look at. Yeah, I don't know what fucking hall I'm in. North Hall. Then that's the one with all the stalls or not. I think so.
Yeah,
it is. It feels very empty. It feels very bare this year. I don't know why. Anyway, let's have a little look and see what we can see. Oh. and see what's going on. Oh wow, it's a castle. Everyone practicing their lightsaber skills. Tauntaun, I'm back where I started. Okay, so let me just loop back around and see where I'm gonna go next. These guys again, these are amazing. Thank you, bro. All 3D printed, no. All resin. Didn't realise that. That's amazing. Oh, that's awesome. Follow, tag, and share. There you go. Well, so I've managed to find a rough Talia, which is awesome. So that's pretty cool.
Get some sneaky ones here if people aren't here as well. So this is what we're giving away right now. PSA 10, Alakazam from Expeditions.
Oh wow. So let's see some times for when we can get some signatures. There we go, there's Dan and Eric. Let's see who they're signing. They sign him now? Nah, I can't, that's not, nah. I was gonna say. So, who do I need? This little Pokemon. So that makes sense. Maybe they're signing soon. Actually, you know what? That's the case.
When the nights got cold, who stole you fire from down below? Look at that, yo! Oh, also I lassoed the sun. Come on, to stretch your days and bring you fun.
You ready? Big finish.
Also I harness the breeze. You're welcome to fill your sails and shake your trees. So what can I say except you're welcome? For the islands I pull from the sea. There's no need to pray.
Real quick, what's your name?
Frank Sabatin.
And what do you do for a living?
I'm a fine artist.
That's fantastic. Is this your first MCM or?
Well, this is the first time I've been to London, but I've been to other Comic Con, but this got to be the biggest con I ever seen.
Very nice. So we're gonna give you some of that American candy that we're talking about. So this is called an Airhead. You ever had one of those before? It's blue raspberry. And you know what, because you're up here, I'll give you another one, there's a cherry one too. So, just so you know, your daily calorie count is in half of one of those. Because again, it's from America. I've worked on it myself, so hey, great job. One more time, give him a huge round of applause. That was awesome. There you go. Did you ever think you, now on your, it's not a resume, it's a CV, right? So now you can put, you performed on stage at MCM Comic Con on your CV. It works wonders for you. I am clearly using my liberal arts degree right now.
Round of applause for Dan Green and Eric Stuart!
Thank guys look great.
Whoa.
How you feeling? Yes.
This is like as many people as I just fired from Kybercorp.
This looks just like my living room.
How are you doing today?
Awesome.
Yeah.
We just got started. Lots of wonderful comments, generous gifts. It's amazing. Even a few people talking about our podcast.
Wow.
The Heart of the Cards. Yeah. Some of you out there,
And I don't know if you were able to see, but when I asked the question of, like, how many of us out there watched this series growing up as kids, we had a lot of hands in the audience. So my question to you is, how has it been kind of coming up with this franchise, seeing it grow, seeing the fan base still as excited about it as ever?
Sure. So when we get these roles in shows, we never know what they're going to become. We never know if the show is going to be successful, whether there's quality to the material. So it's truly a bonus, and it's very humbling that we've had a chance to work on some very successful franchises that also connect with the fan base. I think the secret to these shows is that there is something redeemable about every character, whether you like the hero, or you like the rival, or you like the funny best friend, or whatever it is. We can connect to these shows. It's not rocket science, right? If there's nothing there, it doesn't matter how loud the sound effects are or how much violent, cool weapons they're using. If there's nothing there with the characters, we don't want to watch it. And so playing these two roles, I mean, I love playing Seto Kaiba. I love the dynamic and I love the depth of the character as well, the family relationship. Maybe the facade that he puts on to protect himself from being vulnerable. Things that we can relate to as humans. So being involved in a show where I see people cosplaying as Kaiba or other shows or even Yugi with the hair, it's humbling, it's flattering, and I love the connection with you guys. And we work in a recording studio so much, we don't have the live audience experience. And so getting to meet people in person and hear your stories and your connections.
But seriously, when we're doing our jobs, you know, this is over 20 years ago now, and of course we had no anticipation that it would be popular even at the time, as popular as it was at the time. Certainly no expectation that 20 years later we would be in a position to meet wonderful people like yourself who say such amazingly generous and awesome things about how our work has contributed to your experience, not just growing up, but continuing to grow up through life. I literally had a wonderful exchange with a young man who shared with me that he recently lost his mother. And part of what he was wanting to share with me was how some of what we've done helped him to get through that. And of course, you don't think of that when you're trying to pronounce the card names right and you're like, fit it to the animation. And the idea that something could be compelling is, I think, what is the most exciting thing about doing anything, and whether it's creative or not. So we feel very blessed to be a part of something that has meant so much to so many.
And then
Yami summons Exodia. And why that's such a favorite moment for me is because that's when I first got to understand the breadth that the show asked for. That it spans across time, that it's dealing with godly powers and that sort of a thing. And my background as a theater person helped inform me how to approach that. Because when you're doing theater, you not only are you dealing with plays and stories that may go there, but you're literally in an environment that requires you to address it in a big way, right? So that's a favorite moment of mine. But in terms of like a specific kind of, I have said it's time to duel from time to time. So that's always fun. But it's more fun for me because it's fun for other people. So that's part of it too.
Kaiba has so many great insults, some of which even, it wasn't that much of a stretch for me to be a sarcastic guy like that, which is really surprising.
Not even a little stretch.
I do like you're a third-rate duelist with a fourth-rate dad.
Yeah.
it's just got such a nice cadence to it. But I think the main thing in terms of the Kaiba approach is not necessarily each one of those specific lines, but the whole attitude.
I mean, I could just, you know, order a coffee with sarcasm, and that would be okay, you know? I'm sure you guys have some favorite type of quotes, but yeah, you duel me with fruit is another one, right?
And so, specifically related to voiceover work, because I do know you have a few other projects going on, and I definitely want to get into that, but specifically about voiceover, you're obviously very recognized for your roles in Yu-Gi-Oh! And Pokemon, but is there something you have voiced in your career that you absolutely loved, thought it was so much fun, that maybe you just generally don't speak about as much?
Yeah, actually, we did an episode of our podcast, called The Heart of the Cards, which you might be familiar with that phrase. But in one of those episodes, I discussed having been cast as Odysseus in this animated series. And this is shortly after Yu-Gi-Oh! Started happening. And that's about a few years into me, you know, getting my comfort zone in terms of doing voiceover work. And I was really proud to have gotten that role. It was a prelay, which means it wasn't dubbing. So you're establishing that character for the first time. And some of it we were recording as a group, so you're actually working off the other actors. And when you come from a theater background, that's what you know, that's what you want. And so that was such a wonderful, the scripts were good, the team was good, all of the cast was great. I was flattered to be a part of them, and the series never came out. So yeah, I think that fits the example, yeah.
And he's not the reason it didn't come out.
No, we won't get into that. I will neither confirm nor deny.
So I got to direct a very funny little show called Viva Pinata.
Yes.
Woo!
Right? Which was a better show than it was a game, but whatever. And that was a prelay show, so we got to record the lines individually, and then I would assemble the pacing so it sounded like people were talking to each other. And there was a character that came up in one of the scripts who was in old-time newspaper reporter, Pecky Putchin, who was like film noir, but he was also like a New York quick-talking Brooklyn guy. And throughout my entire career, and I'm born and raised in Brooklyn, I don't talk like the neighborhood guys, but I could, because I grew up around them.
You know what that is.
Right? And no matter what, every show I ever auditioned for where they had that, the New York thing, the Brooklyn thing, they never picked me. They would pick somebody and I'd go, that is the worst. I'm sure you guys can all relate to when someone's doing a fantastic, and I say that in quotes like Kaiba, British accent, and you're like, that's just garbage, right? Exactly. I was like, that's the worst Brooklyn accent? That's the worst, what are they thinking? So when I was directing the show and this character came up, I said, I'm gonna cast myself as this character. And I got to do my Joe Pesci like this, and I'm talking like this the whole time for the whole episode like this, and I'm like an old-time newspaper guy, and I'm like, I'm so proud that I got to represent my neighborhood guys finally. So yeah, you know? So, and I think that's pretty good, don't you? I mean, come on.
Yeah, come on, give it up, right?
Woo! As I say, my name's Andrew. Just a quick question. Favorite duel you've voiced for the series?
When I threatened to jump off the building. Because there doesn't seem to be any other way that they let me win in that show.
Yeah, it's fixed.
Yeah. Yeah, I definitely have the writers on my side, for sure.
I'm not saying anything.
No. But my favorite duel is when we had to team up in the first Yu-Gi-Oh! Movie, where we fought side by side as partners. It just shows what our true relationship is.
Yeah. And duels with Kaiba, duels with Pegasus, duels with Merrick, these all, you know, stand out. But at the risk of sounding extremely narcissistic, when the show concluded and my characters got to duel each other, it's not because I portray those roles, it's because of the structure of the writing. I really admired that there was a beginning, a middle, and end, and I thought that closure was beautiful. So,
yes. Good question.
Yeah.
Thank you for everything.
Thank That's you. Very kind. Thank you. Let's go back over here. I'll do your job for you. How kind of you.
Dan's got it worked out.
Now I'm going to get behind the cameras. And then...
Hello, my name is Lee.
Hi.
I've been a big fan of Yu-Gi-Oh! For 22 years. Awesome. I've been playing it for a very long time. So
it's from the beginning.
If it weren't for this card game, I wouldn't have been doing this today. So again, wow. Thank you.
Thank you.
My first question is, what is your favorite Yu-Gi-Oh! Series when you start doing this?
For me, it's got to be the original. The original. Nothing against the others.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
I mean, the OG. Yes, definitely.
The original, yes.
And you saying that the show helped get you through is a comment that we've heard before. How many people in this room have felt something along those lines?
Yeah.
Now, this is what we mean by feeling grateful. We didn't, some people have attributed things to me that I don't think I deserve. Some people have said, you know, without your work, I wouldn't have gotten through this hard time. And I'm glad that what I did helped that person to get through that hard time, but we didn't get you through that hard time. You did. You did. Thank you.
It's worth it. It's worth playing this game, really. It's worth it.
It's our privilege.
Thank you.
Sure. Yeah. You're a third-rate duelist with a fourth-rate deck.
Yeah. Woo!
Yes.
Grandma always said I could believe in the heart of the cards.
That's right, but if you believe in yourself, you will always prevail. It's time to duel!
Woo!
Thank you, good question, thank you. Hey, nice hat.
You just pulled that out of the closet. You're like, oh yeah, I remember.
Came straight from work.
So, my name's Tom.
Hey.
Been a fan of Yu-Gi-Oh since I was about 5 years old.
Thank you, Tom.
Watched the first episode when I was in primary school. Absolutely loved it. Loved it ever since. So many questions. Probably my most pressing question is, like, my favorite series was season 4 with Darth's big evil character and so on. Who were your favorite antagonists that you ever, you know, recorded lines against and so on?
For me, it's Kai.
Yeah, I think Marek annoyed me a lot.
Yeah.
And
Jonathan Todd Ross is a lovely
character. Yeah, I'm talking character, not actor. And Bakura. I think Dark Bakura annoyed me too, but in a good way. Yeah.
Yeah. So assume, you know, Kaiba, you know, is sort of like the no-brainer. But yeah, I mean, Merrick, that was a great confrontation. But again, getting back to that love I had for the first season, Maximilian Pegasus, wonderfully talented Darren Dunstan, also a great guy. You know, those stand out for sure. And Ted Lewis as Bakura, I love Ted. Yeah, he's one of my best friends.
They're all our friends, but the character that...
That's not a showbiz exaggeration.
Good question, though. Thank you. I said, he's got no lip flap. Can I make him Spanish? And they said, why would he be Spanish? And I said, why wouldn't he be Spanish? And they had no argument for that. So they let me do it because there's no mouth movement, I could do it with pauses. And I did it like that, and they were like, this is great. And then I did a convention in Miami where a lot of the fan base speaks Spanish. And a group of fans came up to me and said, we want to thank you for playing Meta Knight because you were one of the only characters on kids' television that sounded like us, that wasn't a stereotype, that didn't make fun of us. And I didn't even think of it that way. So Meta Knight is a very special character to me because he is so cool, and he represents people without being
and you probably wouldn't be allowed to do that nowadays.
Right, because I'm not of Spanish descent, but I don't know, there you go. That's a whole different other
conversation. It's a whole
different. Yes. But yes, thank you for enjoying that. Yes, great show too, Kirby, right back at you.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
Well, thank you so much for joining us here today. Where can the fine Spanji this weekend?
At our tables.
That's right, we're right next to each other.
Yes, yes. Yeah. Thank you
and
so much.
And we would love to see you there.
Yes.
Yeah. And thank you so much. You've been so kind and said, you know, thank you for being here. Thank you for being here. Without you guys, we wouldn't be anywhere, right? So we owe it all to you.
Yep.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, guys.
Woo!
Okay, so, I've been busy, obviously, you see. Look, flash. I was able to get one signature from Dan Green, went to the panel, went back to the signatures, was able to get a signature from Eric Stuart, so sorted, both golden, both done, and yeah, it's fucking like 3 o'clock now, boy, I'm telling you, 3 o'clock, son. I am absolutely beat. It's gone so quick, and I did see...
Which might be the answer.
I saw a cosplay friend, and he disappeared on me. So, yeah. So I don't know where he is. I'll go find him again. What a git. But, anyway. So, I haven't even probably looked through these things yet. I don't know where to fucking start from. Oh, brother. But maybe we'll go back to Kuma Castle real quick, see what's going on down there. So, yeah. Because I don't know where to start. Vince Wilden Tigger, Winnie the Pooh, that's pretty deep, nifty. Dragons. Not sure I filmed down it yet. I think I have. All I've got is it bending the ink machine in my head, I don't know why. Strange. Pops, things there, art there, bit nice. Sorry. And human cards. So yes, let's have some fun. Whew. Okay, so it's like fucking 5 o'clock now. I don't know what the last time I actually vlogged was, but yeah, met up with my friend, and we had a little chat, a little good time. And yeah. We'll be having fun. So, anyway, I think it is time to end the day for me. It is hot. I have a bit of a backache, and yeah, it's gonna be easier tomorrow to come back and start afresh. So, yeah, I don't know. Lovely people, lovely costumes, and yeah, I don't know. It's been a good day. It's been a decent day today. Got all I wanted to do is done. Tomorrow I'll have a little look around properly and yeah, mosey around what I want to buy. So yeah, gonna head out towards the exit and see the people outside, see how people are outside and you know, cosplaying as I do. So Cosplay Central, 2 trips there, which is great. Main stage. Managed to get obviously a little sneaky footage. Nice. A bit of sneaky footage. Oh god, that smells so delish. I don't know what it is, but it smells delish. God, I'm so hungry. I haven't even eaten all day. But yeah, managed to get some sneaky footage back of Dan Green and Eric Stuart, which is perfect. There's Matt there. So very happy to see those guys and get things signed. I might get more stuff signed by them. I don't know just yet. Depends on the queue tomorrow. The queue tomorrow is going to be absolutely manic. And then, yeah, I don't know. We'll see how we go. We'll see how we go. So yeah, let's carry on to the outside. And I'll see you out there, because I'm taking too long. I'm waffling. Nice. Tell them.
Have you got your badge?
Yes, there, on the phone. Why do you need to get your badge checked to fucking come out? Like, that's just stupid.
So you got your badge?
Yeah. Why? Of course I have. Otherwise I wouldn't be fucking in there, would I, you dick? But then again, I guess this bit's obviously for the cosplay people as well. I don't know. Stupid.
So many peoples.
Yeah, nice. Nice. There we go. So yeah, I'll have a little check, see how bad the queue is at the Comic Con. Probably not too bad. I'm sorry for you, my friend. Jesus. My strap is falling down on my shoulder. He's a good dump out boy. He's a good dog out. All these people. Cosplayers over there, get pictures done. Power Rangers. Nice dog bowl. Good dog bowl. Nice. Power. And Makima. Little bar there apparently. Oh nice. Kung Fu Action Jesus! 02. And coppers. Another power. Oh, look at the dog off. Right, there we go. One more, one first day down of MCM. Oh god, that breeze is lovely. And we shall be back tomorrow. There we go. Goodbye. Excel Center for today. And we shall be back tomorrow. See a bunch of people still there. Having fun. Good for them. Anyway. Some doggos down there somewhere. But yeah, so we are crossing over. It's nice to get out. It's fucking nice to get a bit of wind, a bit of fucking a bit of coolness. So yeah, very, very nice. Just come over the sunset there now. Not really sunset, but like, you know what I mean. Right on the horizon. I've actually got my shield off as well, my chest plate, not my shield. My shield, but it's been bag all day, so my poor shield didn't get to have its debut. Oh well. There's some stuff over there, they're kind of churning up, which is fun. Reminds me of the Gold Rush TV show. Still a ton of work going on to here. And yeah, so we'll be back tomorrow in a different costume. Hopefully something a lot easier to manage and maintain, because fuck me, never again. I might start doing less costumes that are so complex and stuff, and having so many different kind of, I don't know, wearable parts, I guess. But anyway, I will see you guys tomorrow doing the same thing at the same time. So, till then, peace.